Turn on the ground power.
Copy. Ground power is now on.
Chief, turn off the ground power.
Copy. Ground power is now off.
Remove the wheel chocks.
Copy. Wheel chocks are now removed.
Runway 32.
And we clear to take off runway 32, Chevy in one flight.
back. We put you through on the signal of the station and the second time. If no signal is selected, or if you are out of range, the needle will be still with the red flag on the needle. The fourth mode is marked as bad. It is used to set up an offset point from the second station. In either way, with the help of the next two positions of the reactor, mark with the green letter row, which looks like our key, and theta, which is similar to our zero. This mode is useful for instance, determining a rendezvous point for flight, or in order to set up a good initial point for approach before it. Now the describe mode you will follow the indication of the peak arrow where the faint one will always point toward the VOR station. Sure you know, but VOR stands for VHF of the directional radio range. So in other words, the peak needle will be the equivalent of your CDI, while the fit needle will work exactly like on the RMI. On the left of the Tomcat you will find the VOR and the ILS control. The final mode, which I really like, smart down, gear, and it requires a radar lock to be activated. When you have a radar lock or something, the double arrow will show you the bearing to the current target, while the fin arrow will give you an intersection course based on the target speed and aspect. The DME will display the distance. Go ahead and check the function of the different modes as we're going to our waypoint 3. In the meantime, I have to contact Darko. Why don't you push Shuttle 4 on the green radio?
Switch FBW
skydiving?
Two, roger. On it.
Marco, Chevy 2-1, request rejoin.
Chevy 2-1, Marco, proceed to pre-contact at 20,000.
one flight is departing. Thank you for your help.
Two, pushing to waypoint 4. Go green radio channel 3, please.
The Ingwer basket is always a little bit of a workout, isn't it? For the rest of the mission, why don't you take the lead so you can demonstrate you are confident with navigating the Mirage?
At this time. running F-15s or 82s.
All right, then the first thing we have to do is to send them the TACAN and the IF. Go ahead and set up channel 22 X-ray and 108 DCS 2.5.
Respecting TNAC, 6 flights on station and pushing
channel 1 of your radio contact the enemy tower. Then you approach crew. Let me know when you're ready for the next
one. Athena. Copy. Magic report picture clean. Shell on station. Coton 07 over leaving 30 likes.
Athena, Coton 6 copies on. 30 mics till refuel.
the mark.
Into low. You can flame that marker into the right of the mark. The far right?
The less set of goals you're gonna have on your head is gonna be your speed management. Like every other jet out there, we don't really use your speed. We use the angle of attack equivalent. When approach from the Mirage 2000, you want to be around 14 degrees angle of attack, which is going to correspond to an airspeed about 155 to 160. If you raise your feet on the bottom of the head, you're going to see some outside brackets, and you're going to see chevrons going up and down. The brackets symbolize the neighborhood of the 14 degrees angle of attack, and the chevrons are going to be your current angle of attack. To be at the proper approach speed, you need to
a high angle of attack when you're coming for landing.
No. So this is where it gets tricky. If you are perfectly established on that beam and at the right airspeed of about 155-160, then you should see the following indications. You will have a vertical dash line. You will have your flight plus marker right inside the little square. And the square is going to be in between the outside bracket with the chevron right on the bracket.
I'm almost there, just by sweat spot 6. All you have to do is jump to the world runway heading of 309, and you will be waiting for the dash line to center on your head. Once the dash line